protein and got those gains. I took the top off the protein and got those
gains. Yo, welcome back, One Swole Generation, YouTube, and all the other social media networks out there. All right, so you tuned into the results of my 30-day journey of doing 100 push-ups and 100 sit-ups. And man, it was a great journey. It was tough, but it was a great journey. I learned a couple of things I want to share with you guys. So let's talk about why I did it. So the reason why I decided to do 100 squats and 100 push-ups every day for 30 days, which by the way was only body weight, 100 squats and 100 push-ups. So for the squats, I hadn't had a good relationship with squats for the last 3.5 years. This was since I had my patella tendon knee injury where the patella tendon was ruptured, meaning the tendon came off of the bone. Every time I would do any type of leg exercises, my knee would swell up. Sometimes it would lock, and there was a lot of pain. So I kind of just stayed off it, did minimum things on it to kind of build it up. And then with push-ups, since I'm a guy and push-ups is easy, why not add in push-ups as an additional challenge? So that's why I came up with 100 push-ups and the 100 squats, because some people I had seen online doing pull-ups and they was doing push-ups, they was doing squats, so I decided to combine them and go from there. So now, let's talk about what happened in the 30 days of the 100 squats and 100 push-ups. Okay, so for the first 2 weeks, it was kind of difficult. I was knocking out three sets of 34 squats and three sets of 34 push-ups, and I was doing them supersetted, meaning I was doing a set of push-ups and then a set of squats, rest for 45 minutes to a, not minutes, rest for 45 seconds to a minute, all right, and then I do the next set. And what I found is my heart was just freaking pounding. All right, so that third week I decided, okay, let's just see if you can do, how many push-ups can you do straight out? How many squats can you do straight out? With the push-ups, I'm not gonna lie, the whole entire time I struggled with the push-ups, even though it's my favorite exercise. With the push-ups, the most I got up to was one set of 65. And then I finished out with whatever was left to make 100. Now with the squats, I was able to knock out 100 squats in a row. 100 squats in a row. Call that achievement, a real achievement. All right, so now let's talk about the pros and cons of doing 100 push-ups and 100 squats for 30 days. Okay, so the pros for the squats was increased flexibility and endurance. I felt like my knee joints or the ligaments and the tendons around my knees was actually getting stronger. Not completely healed, but I felt like they were stronger. With the push-ups, as my old army people used to say, push-ups build determination, baby. Striations of the nation. But with the push-ups, I felt like since I was doing them every 30 days, my posture improved because I was walking with my chest up and out, which improved the way I was standing and sitting. But it also gave me a great stretch in my chest, bicep, and back. And because I had to maintain great form, it also worked my core muscles and my lower back, which was great overall. So my back wasn't hurting as much as it usually do. So we could say there, push-ups help improve your lower back. Now, let's talk about the cons of doing 100 push-ups and 100 squats for 30 days. So some of the cons for the push-ups and squats is if you're trying to just build muscle, then body weight squats are not for you, all right? Because you're not to build muscle. 30 days of squats and push-up can cause knee and joint issues or elbow issues and that kind of stuff. Actually, I didn't actually experience anything that I hadn't already had prior to starting this program. So the only con that I really got from this for me was actually building some muscle. All right. One of the other things I did learn is that if you're going to do something like this and you have a busy job such as or busy day such as family, job, and that kind of stuff, then you need to manage your time in order to get through it. Because it was sometimes I found myself doing it at 9 o'clock at night and then I had to post a video. Or sometimes I had to double up. And that only happened twice in the 30 days where I had to double up on the push-ups and squats, meaning I had to do 200 squats and 200 push-ups that day because I couldn't do it the day prior because I had prior engagements and I was like, I'll just get it done before that. No, you need to make time to get it done. Did I share something that you might be able to use on your next journey? If you decide to do a 30-day challenge, a 60-day challenge, or a 90-day challenge, if you got something out of this video, don't be afraid to like, comment, and subscribe, and please share, because in the year 2020, we coming, baby. We coming.